guys doing? I hope you're having a fantastic day. Welcome to Entertainment News right here on Y254 TV. I hope you're washing your hands as many times as possible, sanitizing, and, you know, just staying at home whenever possible, staying safe during these corona times. Now, welcome to the show. We're going to have an amazing show tonight. My name is Feline, at Feline Jean, across all socials. And, of course, the hashtag is Y254 updates. We are also on social media at Y254. That's on Facebook. Talk to us. And we're going to be sampling some of your comments at the end of the show. Now, what is the show all about? It's all about celebrity gossip. What have our celebs been up to? We're about to get to catch you up, rather. But before we do that, meet Dennis, aka the Mwangis. He's in the studio with me right now. What's up?
Yo, what's up? Thanks for having me.
You're always welcome. Of course.
Tunakachukua. Tunakapepetea. I go by the name Dennis Bob Miner across all social media platforms. Thank you for tuning. Thank you for watching us na Tujibambe.
Exactly. Yes. And we have the other guys at home. I don't know. We're having some technical issues, but Tona, if we can get them on the show, they're going to be joining us. Shout out to Ronald and shout out to JC as well. They are on standby. They're going to be joining us, hopefully, right? Now, we're going to go to the first story. Shout out to Mwangis right here always having my back. All right. So, now, first story. It is what it is.
Yeah? It is what it is.
Exactly. Now, it's not news that most countries, among them Kenya, are looking forward to beating the COVID-19, which has affected most businesses. Now, restaurants and eateries are one of the most affected sectors, but recently the government of Kenya allowed reopening of restaurants that are willing to follow regulations put in place to ensure the safety of customers who want to eat out. Now, one of the regulations was that customers must order food first and then maybe order alcoholic beverages, but some Kenyans took advantage of the situation and are now ordering, according to CS Mutahi Kagwe, one sausage and a lot of alcohol. We actually have a video for that. Let's have a look. All right, we're gonna be playing for you the video in just a minute, but okay, first of all, Kagwe, I'm going to remind children at home, Anetua, he's the CS of health, his name is Mutahi Kagwe, nasi mutu wa corona, tafadhali. Let's stop calling him that. That's number one. And number two, come on, restaurants ilifunguliwa ndo watu wakule. Unfortunately, watu wanaenda kukunywa. Mtu anaorder sausage moja, alafu anaorder beer tatu. What?
You see, in everything that goes on, kuna kitu itakuwa loophole. Loophole is to yote when they just say that they are going to be opening all the eateries and the restaurants for people to eat.
All right, carry on.
They decided to open all the eateries and all the restaurants. They didn't say how much you should eat for you to drink how much. And hapo ndio kama walikosania na Wakenya. Unajua? So Kenyans are just trying to be creative in their own way. Oh, remember when you were chini and you know, hii kitu tumeikosa. Okay, wameikosa sana for as in lack of the fact that people don't go out clubbing, people don't go out drinking, people are not, like, social life imeharibika.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, wanaambiwa niaje, unaweza ingia ka hoteli, uitishe ka food, ile food wewe utaitisha, it's food.
Yeah.
You know, and food is classified, hata kitu kidogo hivi is classified. But Kagwe went so far to even classify how Kenyans are doing it. Sausage moja hapa, alafu unajua that regulation says, right after you finish eating, you can only stay there for 30 minutes.
30 minutes, yes.
So, what you do, you take your sausage, your two beers. Actually, hiyo kitu sahi kwa menu, the menus that we are seeing nowadays, zimebadilishwa. Unaingia hivi, unasema, letea mimi Mutahi Kagwe. And that's what we're consulted. So, alafu nasikia mtu anamalizia na pale mwisho na kuitisha shugo. So,
yeah, but that's what he said. I don't know if you guys watched the video. According to the video, CS alisema, you go to one restaurant, after umemaliza kukula, unaenda ya pili, unakula sausage moja, utoke, ya mwisho unaenda kukula chungwa moja. Na bia tatu, unajua, na bia tatu alafu unasema, hiyo sasa ni, unajua, like, ile fruit mtu kula after,
dessert,
yeah, exactly. So, hiyo chungwa ni dessert. So, unaitisha chungwa na bia.
It's a balanced diet. No. Alafu pia wezi expect mtu waenda kukula, kuna food wezi kula na kamnyweso. You know, kuna vitu wezi kula na kamnyo. So, it's understandable. Kasosija kaezi kuharibikia. Unajua, kuna vitu zingine hebu jaribu kuchanganya changanya. Utaona vile watu
watanini hapa. Kula githeri, maze. Kula
githeri. Jaribu kula githeri, alafu usindikize na mbili. Utaziona mahali. Utajua ni kula chakula ya kuku wewe.
So I'm gonna be telling you guys, I don't know, we can't roll the video right now, but maybe we're gonna get it for you later on. But we're gonna move on to the next story. The hashtag is Y254 updates. All right, actually we actually have the video. The video is ready, so let's have a look at the video. Yes, let's have a look at the video so that you guys will know what we're talking about.
It is a fact of life that people have been going to pubs or to eateries. They order one sausage with two beers, they eat that one sausage, anakula hiyo sausage moja na bia mbili, anatoka hapo, anaingia hoteli ingine, huko anakula bia mbili ingine, na sausage ingine moja, anaingia ingine, anauliza chungwa, risasa ni dessert, na ingine mbili. It is a fact of life that people have been going to pubs or to eateries. They order one sausage with two beers. They eat that one sausage. Anakula hiyo sausage moja na bia mbili. Anatoka hapo. Anaingia hoteli ingine. Huko anakula bia mbili ingine na sausage ingine moja. Anaingia ingine. Anauliza chungwa. Risasa ni dessert. Na ingine mbili.
Like, yeah, yeah. Y'all are just like too funny. You have to stop. So,
actually, what is going on currently? As Mutahi is bringing the COVID briefing,
yeah.
Kenyans are now busy making memes. He's giving memes supply daily.
Yeah.
Why are you doing evil? Kako is trending more than the memes in Yetumezoea. Daily.
Actually, so other people. There's someone who's saying, I'm like, ati nyinyi mkikunywa chai yenu ya 4 million. Sisi tuliwa sumbua.
Exactly.
Like, but anyway, it's not funny. Let's stay safe. Yeah, let's remember the whole point is staying safe, sanitizing, washing your hands. We have to beat this corona. We have to stay alive. And on that note, we're going to go to the next story. Now, social media went into a frenzy when news broke that Willis Roburu and his wife of 2 years, Mary Prude, had allegedly called it quits because of a Ugandan lady. Now, but just a day later, they said lady by the name Miva Noella came clean through a friend on Edgar Obare's story. Shout out to Edgar, by the way. To claim that she was in fact Rwandese and not Ugandan, and that she had never met Willis Roburu in her life. She was actually surprised why anyone will go out of their way to tarnish her name and be mean to her for no reason. Even with all this drama, Roburu is yet to address the issue. All right, so Kenyans, meme lords, what's wrong with you? So there, apparently, I don't know, it's alleged that Willis Roburu and Prude apparently called it quits. They are no longer married. I don't know how true that is because they had an amazing wedding 2 years ago, and we're just like so happy for them. They were goals, but unfortunately, it said that they are no longer together. We don't know how true that is. So they said, you remember when you're taking your vows? till death do us part. So kasema, who damn? Yendo death. Like till death. Death has come between. Not funny. So apparently, walikuwa wamesema kwanza ni Uganda, and then no, they said like udema kuja kajitetea. Like she's like, I've never met Willis in my life. I don't even know who he is. So she's being dragged on social media for all the wrong reasons. What do you have to say about that?
I was arguing with a friend about this. At first, I thought this Chile was the one who was like doing this kiki.
Mm-hmm.
At first, but then actually. It's unconfirmed that Willis has tried to respond to it, but what he's saying is that the wife is threatening, but it's unconfirmed.
Mm-hmm.
The wife is threatening her. Warudiane ama kiumane.
How?
I'm like wondering why Willis, nini unajaribu kufanya now when you're trying to pull off these stunts? Si ngoma utatoa? You know, like, you've already hit that level, yenye. You don't need Kiki to survive.
Yeah.
So I don't understand why he can pull off such a stunt if it's him or whoever is trying to pull off this stunt, because
mm-hmm.
Udem, honestly, the mtu unajua Edgar ndio amekuwa ni kama SI unit.
Tea master.
Ukiona kimekumania, just to make things clear, just go to Edgar.
Yeah.
And things would just be
clarified.
Yes. So for her to go to Edgar, I'm really sure she didn't like just go for the clout.
Yeah.
She was just trying to clear her name.
Yeah, exactly. But here's the thing I don't understand. Like, you know, we talked about Aziyah. Do you remember the Utawezana stuff? Apparently, watu wakakuja na rumors, oh, Wasafi walimpea job akakata, which was not true. She confirmed it wasn't true. Sai sijui ati Will sijui wife is threatening him. I don't think there's any truth to that. By the way, here's the thing. There's a lot of fake news out here, so you have to be careful. Don't just trust, don't believe everything you read. True. I think that's all I have to say.
Not all sources are legit.
Yeah, not everybody is just going
only
to tell you.
Only one legit source, the tea master. Tunajua. Hiyo tukienda kwa stories, hiyo tunazichambua kulichambua. Edgar, endelea na kazi mzuri. Yako ni confirmed sources.
Yeah, not even Edgar. Sometimes people go out tell Edgar stories that are not true. Sometimes they'll say, you saw and so broke up, and then you see them together. So they're not like always true. So you have to always find the truth in all those stories. What would you want to penda udaku, I think. And that's why we are here. So we see a pin in udaku. And you can be part of the show. Yeah? The hashtag is Y254 updates. Just head over to Facebook at Y254. That is our page. We have a photo, so go comment below any comment you want to tell us about the show. And we're gonna be sampling it at the end of the show. Where are you even watching us from? And what you have to say about these stories. And shout out to everybody. Shout out to JC, shout out to Ronald, shout out to Hafulu Imboko, Mwenye Potea, by the way. Yes, and shout out to Jesse Mugure, Junil, Biatora, Giovanni, shout out to Janet, and the whole gang. But on that note, we're gonna go to another interesting story, which is also very funny. Now, a video is making rounds on social media of a Kenyan police car allegedly playing the death song during curfew hours while on patrol. The song by the name Astronomia was released back in 2014 by Vystone and Tony, but went viral recently. The song is used mostly to show Ghanaian pallbearers in black suits and sunglasses grooving a house beat while carrying a coffin. They perform in funerals to make mourners feel a little bit better when sending off their loved ones. But in this scenario, the song is used as a warning to those engaging in risky behaviors during coronavirus pandemic. So, there's a video. We're going to be playing it for you guys in just a little bit. But you're familiar now. You know that one. You go, mama, say, any other kid that you want to go, you can't do that. You can't do that. You can't do that. You can't do that. Kidogo wanatoka kwa na sanduku wamebeba. It's not, I don't know how hiyo wimbo na hiyo ngoma like na hiyo video zinaenda nao wasee zilipatana, but they've been making our quarantine period worthwhile. So kuna hii video wanasema makara wa Kenya walikuwa na, actually it was in Italy. They did that in Italy. Police officers did that. They were playing that, they were patrolling in their cars playing that song. So there's a video claiming that even the Kenyan police are doing that during curfew hours. A curfew hours is not even about corona. Ni about Buddha ukishikwa. Kola sahi, but you can't say you just come home. You should be. Unapo kuna scare you imo from far. Kako hapa unaka scare. Tantara.
But mewe hapa karama likuwa janda.
Yeah.
But, okay. In a way, we try to solve modern problems with modern solutions as much as you what they are trying to do.
Yeah.
So I'm just trying to imagine ule karao alikuwa pale. Huo ni meme lord. Huo si karao.
Huo
ni meme lord.
Yaani supplier. Yeah.
Actually ni lazima jua bus. Unajua ile system yao yeye huwa anafanya hivi inapiga masauti huko.
Yeah, exactly.
Asante vile anaweza weka headset.
Siren.
Alafu weke ngoma hapo juu, alafu si ngoma yote. Tum tum.
I got to beat.
Cops.
I know, right? But I just love these little things. Like, they make us sometimes forget what is really happening about, like, coronavirus. So many people are frustrated, but it can happen, yeah? Even makarau wako na sense of humor. It's not just like ati.
They're humans too, true. They're humans.
Yeah.
Whatever they're doing, I'm sure there's that discussion before that.
Mm-hmm.
Kuna ka discussion. How can discussion go define vita unapigwa inatoshana aje. Kutoka wapi unaenda wapi, you know, vile utajibu simama kama umeketi. So all those things, vile utajibu ndio determine ile vita utapata nayo iko namna gani.
But do you think they discuss vile umesema ati simama kama umeketi, wana practice, unajua, like before the show, the way people prep, sijui nini, I have a script. Sasa wao wanakaanga ati eh, but they good leo nitauliza mtu nini, ati simama kama umeketi ama kama sijui kama umefanya nini, ama zile ma frog jump ufanyisha wase, alafu wanaanza kucheka
kitu gani unajua ufanyisha ufanya before kuja kutuvuruga mtaa. Hazo ufanyaga psych. Iyo leo najua. Hazo ufanyaga psych.
Do you think...
Panda, steam. Iyo lazima wafanye. Alamu wakutuwa wakuja mtaa. Hazo
wakutuwa kutuvuruga. I don't know how true that is. Do this. Let's have a look at the video.
No, but...
Shoot video ange chukua mingi cause he knew maybe akomali afai kukua.
This video actually ukiona ikianza huyu jamaa anaanzia mbali apparently,
yeah.
Alafu ikianza kukaribia kwanza msi anajificha, actually msi kwanza anajificha, ana take position kwanza alafu ndio atoe camera tena. Eh, unajua
walai mimi nika kwanzia nisikie wewe ni kala na hiyo ndo soundtrack wanacheza mimi na faint.
Hapo niko.
No, just kind of. Najipeleka. I'm like, hi, I'm here. Like, just.
Haki nimechelewa.
Yeah, nipeleke ni quarantine. But then, you know, definitely unapelekwa quarantine. That is number.
Apparently,
yes, that's some good news.
It's free.
By the way, kishikuwa sahi quarantine is free of charge. So, what was he? Ogope kupimwa. All right, on to another story. Now, alright, Bongo star Harmonize shared an emotional post on his Instagram regarding his former colleague at WCB Wasafi Records, Rich Mavoko. Now, it's been 5 months since Mavoko appeared in public or posted anything. His last post dates back to New Year. According to his post, Harmonize said that it hurts him seeing his talented brother quiet and without any explanation. He went ahead to say that some fans should stop celebrating Mavoko's absence since he might be working behind the scenes. And even though it seemed like his concern came from a good place, most of the fans on his comment section didn't take it well, with some asking him to sign the letter or others saying that he might be the next one since he left Wasafi too, just like Rich Mavoko. Mavoko, raho yangu, niachie wewe nenda. You remember that song? That was such a big hit. Like, I don't know, what happens when people go to Wasafi? Nini lifanyikia Rich Mavoko? He was doing well on his own. I don't know why he had to go to Wasafi. What do you think happened to him? Because after ametoka Wasafi, we no longer hear about him. Hata tujui anaendelea aje. What's going on? Adi yuko social media. He's not been posting. He's not been appearing anywhere. No one knows about his whereabouts.
About this thing, I think sometimes ago when somebody left Wasafi and we said this contract these people sign, mm-hmm. sometimes you know,
yeah, that is the post Harmonize actually put on his Instagram. Lakini ni Kiswahili mingi, tuanze Kiswahili kingi, si mingi, Kiswahili mingi.
Alright, so
this one I can actually read for you guys. Mimi naweza wasomea, like kama unajua Kiswahili, yeah? If you know Kiswahili, then I can read for you. Anasema, familia ngapi zipo nyuma ya Rich Mavoko na zinamtegemea yeye kwa kila jambo, hasa hili la kupata mkate wa kila siku. Vipi kuhusu ndoto za familia hizo na zinaishije katika wakati huu? Ndoto ngapi za wasanii ambao wanategemea zifikia hizi ndoto kupitia Mavoko, na nyuma ya hao wasanii kuna familia nyingine pia. Je, maumivu, malalamiko ya wazazi wake, hasa mama mzazi ambaye ndiyo kama roho yake. Ushajiuliza ni kauli ngapi za uchungu anazozitoa ambazo zinaweza kumpata kila anayefurahishwa na hili kwa makusudi? Maana mzazi wa mwenzio ni wako pia. Laana yake haishindwi kukupata. La mwisho kabisa, mgeukie mwenzio anayefurahia na kuifanya hii kuwa ni habari njema kwake, ya kumfanya atembee kifua mbele na hata kuandika mtandaoni kwa furaha, Mavoko kapotea, muulize anayefaidika na nini? Alright, and then he goes ahead to say Mungu ana sababu na maana yake. Bro Rich Mavoko akamtag, yeah? Kama mdogo wako na kuombea, najua ukimya wako una maana kubwa sana na ndani yako ninachojua ni kujiweka sawa na kutuletea wepesi kazi zingine. Tunakupenda na tunakuombea Mungu akufanyie wepesi. Let's go bro, mdogo wako, rafiki yako, nipo hapa muda wowote. Ramadan Karim. Was he coming from the right place? Was he right to write that? Like, okay, in short, anasema tu like watu wache people should stop making fun of Rich Mavoko. Unaelewa? Like, he's gonna be back. Maybe he's just working behind the scenes. And they should be thinking about his family, especially his mom. You know, moms are very important. So, I don't know why people are making fun of him. Like, umepotelea wapi tangu toke Wasafi, sijui nini nini. Unajua, ni kama kumambia hange toka. Like, you made the wrong decision. You know, we can't go back from where we came from. Asha toka Wasafi, asha toka sa. What do you guys want him to do?
Harmonize. I have to tell you this.
Ama atafuta kiki na ye.
Exactly. We know you. Umekuwa idle sana. You have not been having anything. Sasa umefikiria hivi, umeanza kufikiria vile utatuambia story ya Rich Mavoko. By the way, we're in not for that story. Hata wewe hatujui kwenye uko. We don't know you. We don't. Hatukujui.
But people had like a lot to say. Actually, I'm gonna just quote some of the guys. Kuna Kide Boy TZ anamwambia, "Aya, mchukue muweke Konde Gang. Labda utapata kiki kwa wiki mbili tu."
Exactly.
That's why in comment. Mwingine akamwambia the funny backbench, anamwambia hata wewe ungejichanganya Rayvanny angekuwa amekupost. Mwingine anamwambia na wewe uko njiani, tutakusahau. Si tuko busy na maandalizi ya uzinduzi wa Wasafi Tower. I'm like, what? Like, atuwezi fanikiwa bila kusave. So, kuna ingine wanambia Rich Mavoko, like, atuwezi fanikiwa bila kusave. So, he should have been smarter and get save. But most guys were just, like, throwing jabs at Harmonize. Wakimambia,
exactly.
Like, sujishugulisha na yako. Like, unbono tafta kiki, sijui nini nini.
You know, if he's really interested to help Rich Mavoko, as he's trying to show us, call him.
Right?
Mpigie muulize bro.
But there's another thing.
Uko wapi? Wacha kutembea kwa
simu. Ako na namba yake.
Exactly.
Na kitaka atampata.
They've been friends. They've been on Wasafi. Jamani kiki anatafuta na jamaa. And as I told you, we don't know you. You're irrelevant. Kama sio kutuambia mambo ya Rich Mavoko, hata atunge kwa tunakukumbuka. Wende huko na konde zako huko.
And speaking of Wasafi, let's go to the next story. Now, business woman and Diamond Platnumz baby mama Zari Hassan seems to have let the beef with the ex-lover slide. While running errands in South Africa, where she resides, Zari recorded herself in the car listening to Diamond's song Jeje. This comes just days after Diamond shared videos on his Instagram talking to his kids on video. Zari has in the recent past, called out Diamond for neglecting his children and being a deadbeat. But that seems to be in the past now. Are they getting back together? That is the big question. I don't know. Are they getting back together? Ama tungoje tutaona. Ama, like, what is going on? You know, not even so long ago. First of all, before even Tanasha got with Diamond, Zari alimwambia ati asijaribu Diamond atamwacha tu. And if she's planning to get with Diamond, she should be ready to be a single mom. mother, he is irresponsible. So she had really bad things to say. And just 2 weeks ago, Diamond akisema vile atadonate, sijui atalipia some 500 families rent. Zari was like, you're neglecting your own family and you're helping strangers, sijui nini nini. And right now, she's taking videos, watoto wameja kwa page ya Diamond, wanashinda wakiongea na baba yao. Do you think it's about the money or are they like in love? Because even I saw Diamond's sister akwapo kwa comment section and she's so happy about that, even the mom. So the whole family, what's happening?
Karantini ikiingia, jamani, watu wanapofungiwa nyumbani, hali inakuwa ndo hiyo sasa jamani. Inakuwa kwamba wewe ambaye uko pale nyumbani, wewe unaanza kufikiria kwamba mpenzio ambaye mliachana sijui miezi ngapi ilipita, ndo huyo, unaanza kumsumbua ex wako. Zari, move on.
Wow. Mother,
yeah, move on.
Wow. So why do you think it's Zari who hasn't moved on? It might be as well be Diamond is the one maybe who's been calling her.
Diamond has not moved on.
There was also
how?
There was a, Zari was dating some alikuwa anaitwa nani? Be something. Be mwenye hakuonyesha though. She was dating. So I don't know what happened to him.
Zari move on. Baby, acha nikwambie. Hii story yote imezunguka huyo dem Zari. You know, it's very simple. The moment Diamond decided to move in with Tanasha and like date Tanasha, Zari became salty. The moment they broke up, in a way, ni vila tu angeanza kusema vile, amefurahia. And all of a sudden, just when Diamond was trying to become nice to their community and try to make things, she seized her moment.
Yeah.
Akamwambia yeye ni aje, wewe kazi yako ni kusaidia watu na huku nje na hadi kwangu home, aujue watoto wako wako
wanakula nini.
She was just looking for opportunity to talk to Diamond. She has it. Now she can play Jeje the way she wants. She can call him, the kids can talk. And trust you me, after quarantine,
there'll be a new bae. Diamond is going to have a new bae. You think?
And you know, Zari, you it's very unfortunate that even after this period is over, because this is where I would say Zari is drunk doing these things. Unajua ile mtu anaenda na kata maji unaanza kupigia ex wako. This is what she's doing at this point.
So drunk dialing.
Whatever she's doing now when she gets sober, Diamond atakuwa amemove on.
Okay.
Na utakuwa tu hapo.
Okay.
And you'll be calling people again. Utaanza kikizako tena. So just move on. As early as now. As I was saying, there are people in Kenya who are single and they are very willing to... Yes. As I was saying, yes. So,
by the way, by people he means him. Zari, Dennis is single and he needs your love. Yeah?
Hashtag.
Hashtag. Hashtag YT54 updates. Now, let's go to another story. Now, right here, back home. Social media, we all know, is nowadays a place where fans get a slight invite to their favorite celebrities' lives. Now, while some celebs are very open to show their houses, spouses, kids, some choose to leave private lives. In her recent live video on Instagram, rather, Avril revealed that most of her fans want her to show them her son's face, something she is not comfortable with. Avril said that she will let the child decide when he's old enough whether to be in the spotlight or not, and that's why he'll never post his face anywhere, anytime soon. That is Avril being a mother. Do you think that's fair for the fans who are like been waiting for the longest time just to have a look at the face? What does the baby look like? But she's like, no, mtoto wangu maybe hataki kuwa famous and I don't want to make him famous. If he wants to become famous, he's going to do that on his own when he's old enough to understand social media, you know, because right now there's a lot of negativity on social media. Do you think that's the right step to take as a parent? Ama as a celebrity, she is failing the fans.
That is a wife material mita 10 plus. Huyo ako sawa. Huyo ako sawa. Avril, she knows how to, I really appreciate her way of handling social media. Kuna limits.
Yeah.
Kuna zile limits. Kuna kitu mafans watakuitisha, and trust you me, if you give that thing, it's going to be at your disadvantage. Utaumia.
Yeah.
Akitoa picha ya mtoi wake, Trust you me, very soon utasikia watu wakianza kumcompare na mtu your Diamond, sijui mtu your Nameless. Itakuwa something. The comparison is what now brings in things that
the way people are comparing Diamond's kids to Alikiba's kids, yeah, and Tanasha's babies to Hamisa's, to Zari's. So that's the whole thing. Yeah.
Can you imagine that kid is very young, and when the kid now gets to age, anapata, when he was 5 years or 3 years, he was trending for all the wrong reasons.
Exactly.
Kama ile wanasema ya Tanasha, you know, we understand all these things. Clouds kusema mtu ya Tanasha, maybe see a Diamond. We have seen these things.
Yeah.
Can you imagine that kid when he or she grows up and finds out that some years ago, people used to say that the father
he or she knows
is not the father.
And that's just according to the people. But they are completely wrong about that.
And that kid will go to school.
Yeah.
That kid will have a social life. That kid will have friends. And those friends, those things, those small things are the things that they used to hurt you.
Yeah. It affects the kids.
And that kid will not be as strong as possible. Tunalea watoto wakuleta wakucheza PS kwa nyumba. Because now, look at this thing of video chatting and everything. Kids can't even make meaningful connections with people. Simply because they are hiding. And why are they hiding? Their parents made them hide. So Avril, kanyagia hapo hapo, mita kumi plus.
And it's so deep. He is so deep into this. I'm just like, okay, will you sound udaku? Buda. Like,
you know, we try to.
I can see that, but shut up. I think that's also commendable. I love to commend that. I really, that's amazing. I wouldn't want, I don't know, my baby's face to be everywhere also, maybe. Why? But come on, my fans. So the fans are always right.
No.
The clients are always right now, no client. See, my fans, no clients.
Those are your enemies. You should know that. Your fans are your enemies.
Right. So, real quick, I'm going to be shouting out a few people right here who are on Facebook. I told you guys to head over to Facebook and comment below. There are some posts. Just go comment below and we're going to be shouting you out. So let me shout out a few people who are on the TL right now. Ras Bashir Were Wabusia, he is always tuned in. Shout out to you. As I'm watching at For Jesus Busia, I have Bram Weke Kaya and I say, pick up Harmonize. Okay, Niite Mzinga wa Magena. Wow, that's a name. The only Gina anasema updates. Mgina anasema Samuel Ngugi anasema watching. Shout out to you, by the way. And I have some guys right here as well. I want to shout out Pato. Shout out to you, Pato. Thank you so much for watching. Mose. Hi, Mose. He's watching. Mashua Naivasha. Hi, it's been a minute. Alafu, there's Joanne. Shout out to Joanne Njeri from Keru. Goya, hi John, and then there's Roba. Oh, Khalifa, shout out to our very own Khalifa. You know, every single Friday, why in the morning on Friday he plays right here. Shout out to you, he is watching the show as well. And I have some more guys on Facebook, I just want to shout them out real quick, and then maybe you can get out of here. Bio. Let's see. All right, right here, who am I seeing? Okay. Omo Sayansi Nyabuto. That's actually his name. And some DJ Darius from Bamburi, Mombasa. Nikiwa na my daughter. Oh, and they even sent a photo of them. They're so cute. Head over to our Facebook if you want to see them. And some blessings show equalit. Tupeleke na hiyo rada. Yes. Enzol baby. And some Mranga County log. Shout out to Mranga, by the way. No. Nivile tu saye tuzi toka Nairobi. Maze ni kafu too, but. Toko tunatembea. Okay. Bram Weke Kea anasema Auto Tulwet Kitale, well represented. Shout out to you. Favored Kim tuned in. Arathika Morris Jacob Makoha. Okay, now I'm just gonna read names because I can't read. Morris Jacob Makoha, shout out to you. Judah Thagon, hey, no, me to my picture. Shout out to you. Samuel Ngugi, Lucas Liza, shout out to you. Babalao, Favored Kim, Robert Machimbo, Mike Akombe, Joseph Seja. All right, there's so many. Abel Kiprice, the Devi Kido, shout out to you, and everyone else who made the show possible. Mother Susie, so much love to time. We gotta get out of here. We have another show coming up. But shout out to Dennis Bob Miner. What's your social media?
Dennis Bob Miner across all social media platforms. Allow me to shout out Demo Meru. I to Christine Mumeru. I'm sure you're watching somewhere there. Thank you very much for tuning in, and it's always a good time. Please, people, sanitize, stay safe, and try your level best.
All right. So, thank you so much, guys, for watching. Shout out to Elivo. It's his birthday right here. Shout out to Timo. Shout out to Roz. Shout out to Mose. All of you. We're going to see you guys again next week with an amazing show. Shout out to JC and Ronald. Thank you so much, guys. See you again next week. Have an amazing evening.
Happy birthday, Elvo.
Happy birthday, Elvo. Oh, happy birthday.